Hello dear traders, my name is Petko Aleksandrov from EA Forex Academy, and in this video I will show you exactly how to export the historical data for EA Studio, because this is very important when you're creating strategies over there and you export them in MetaTrader to have the same results in MetaTrader backtest and the same results in your EA Studio. Also, I will update all previous courses with this video that I am using EA Studio. Okay, so once you have the script and you need to copy it and you need to go to File, Open Data Folder, and you go to MQL4, you go to Scripts, and then you paste it. Alright, you close the folder, you go to Scripts, and you refresh. After that, it will show over here. Let's make it just a little bit bigger. And I click the plus. So this is the script that we are using for EA Studio. EA Studio data export. Okay, what you need to do is you click right button of your mouse. You go to modify. And here you will see all the settings for the EA Studio. So here are the maximum bars that you would like to export. Here is the spread and here is the commission. These are the three most important things that you need to set up. So now I will minimize that. I will go, for example, to Euro Dollar, and I will click right button and I will click on spread. So now you can see the spread for all of your instruments going down. And what you need to do, since most of the brokers are having floating spread, as you can see at the moment is 3, is changing to 4, 5, sometimes it's coming lower to 2 and to 1. That's why EA Studio by default it comes with 10. Okay, so the strategies that we will be building, they are with the highest spread. This is the worst case scenario for the spread. Okay, meaning that the strategies that we will create in EA Studio, they will be with the higher spread of 10. And in the normal situation, on the normal market after that, you will have less spread. Of course, you can set it exactly if your spread is stable. But what I suggest you, give it always a little bit bigger. So the results in EA Studio will be the worst case scenario for the spread. And when you put the expert advisor after that in your MetaTrader, actually you will be expecting better results because the spread will be less. And the other thing, guys, is the commission. Okay, as you see in the account history of this account, I have for 0.01 lot size, I have 0.06 as a commission. The commission comes from the broker. Not all of the brokers has commission, mostly the ECN brokers have commissions. But if you have it, you should put it as well in your script, so you will have precise results. Okay, so as you can see here, what it says in the code is that commission in currency per lot. Okay, so what I have to write over here is 6. Okay, because 0.06 I have for 0.01. So for 0.1 it will be 0.6. And for one lot size trading it will be 6. And the other thing again is the spread. If you have the floating spread, 5, 6, 7, going to 10. As you can see here, the most traded currency, they have spread below 10. This is in points. Okay, so I will leave it to 10. Okay, and as well I will put the maximum bar to 200. Okay, so once again you need to set up only the values in red. This is the maximum bar, the spread, and the commission. All right, after that you click on compile and your EA Studio data export script is ready. So what I will do, I will click on the EA Studio data export, I will drag it over the chart, and as you can see all the bars were exported. On Euro Dollar M1 I have 200,000 bars, and for the others I have more. So basically, what you need to do before that, actually, if you just downloaded your MetaTrader and you just installed your MetaTrader, you need to go to all-time frames and you need to press the home key of your keyboard. Okay, so your M1, press the home key and the chart will be loading over here. And until the maximum you can have from your broker, then you go to M5 and you press again the home key. Then you go to M15, you press the home key, M30. I have already done that, that's why it's not loading anymore. But this is the thing you need to do every time in the beginning. And of course, you need to do it for the rest of the currencies that you want to trade or any other instruments that you want to trade. Keep in mind that some pairs have higher spread. So if you're trading, for example, these ones over here, you should be placing at least spread of 20. Or if you're having some currency as Aussie Swiss, for example, I don't think anybody would be trading Aussie Swiss, but if you are, you should have spread even above 20. All right. So after that, you go to file, open data folder, you go to MQL4 and to file. This is the recent Euro dollar that we have exported. So I will copy that. And I will leave them in a file called data, but you can actually copy this in anywhere you wish. Just collect your data in one folder. And after that, guys, what you need to do is actually to test if everything you set is properly and if you will be receiving the same results in your EA Studio and in the MetaTrader backtester. Okay. So I will go now to EA Studio. I will click on tools and in data import is where you need to import your data from the folder. So these files over here, what you need to do is you select them and you drag them over here in this field. As you can see, your data is uploaded over here. First is imported, then is uploaded. But I see here now a limitation of 100,000. This comes from EA Studio. So when you go to Data Horizon, you can change the maximum data bars to 200,000. Okay, this is the maximum you can have in EA Studio. From over here is if you want to use start date limit or use end day limit. All right, and now again, I will be importing just the data for M1 and M5 because these were bigger than 100,000. Okay, I will put this one over here and I will drag this one over here. So as you can see, on M1, I have 200,000 and on M5, I have 175,578. All right. So after that, I will go to the generator. I have some strategies here in collection. I will remove them and I will go to the generator. You select your broker. So for the purpose of this video, I'm using the GFD broker in the demo. And here you select the currency that you wish. Now we import it. Let's see exactly. This is the time. And what I will do right now, I will just click simply start and I wish the generator to create just some strategy. Doesn't matter what is it. As you can see, I have already in collection some strategy. So I will stop the generator and I will click on this strategy. It doesn't matter what entry conditions it has or exit conditions. All you need to do is now to export this strategy. Okay. And I will save it in the folder where is my data, for example. Okay, I will open and I will copy this strategy. Then I will go to my MetaTrader. I'm going again to file, open data folder. I go to MQL4 and I go to experts. Then I will be pasting this strategy over there. I have a lot of strategies actually here testing at the moment. So this is the strategy on M15 ending. Now I will just rename it just to make sure I don't mistaken it. So I will say just test strategy. Okay. I will close this folder I will go to experts right over here on the navigator menu, and I will click on refresh. Once it's ready, I will look for it. Let's make it a little bit bigger so I can see where is this test strategy. It's right over here, but this is on M15. So I go to M15 and I will be putting this strategy over here. Okay, the first thing you need to see that everything is working. You have the smiley face over here. And of course, you need to wait a little bit to see if actually your MetaTrader will open the positions. But everything, if you've done everything correctly, it should open them. And then what you need to do, you click right button, you go to expert advisors, and then you go to strategy tester. Okay, so right over here, I will select, it's already there actually because I selected from the chart. It's your strategy, it's an Euro-Dollar. The model you need to choose, guys, open price only, because this every tick model, it's not real from MetaTrader. It's a long thing to talk about, but I don't want to talk in this video about it. It's just the best thing you can do is to test by open prices only. All right. And spread, you need to do it the same way that you selected to do it in your script. So I will choose 10 and simply I will press start. All right. Let's see what is the result. I think this is very similar to what I had actually in the EA studio. It's hard to say because it's just up and down. This was just the first strategy that we selected, but to make sure we have the same results, I will click on the balance chart and then I will go to the journal. This is where you see all the results from the strategy. Okay, and I will look as well in results over here. So this is where you see also the results from MetaTrader. Okay, so once again, I will open it right over here. Let's make it the way that we can see bot. Okay, so this is EA Studio and here we have. Okay, so just a second, guys, because this is on my virtual private server on the VPS and this is not. So I think this way we should be able to see. As you can see, we have the very same results, -52.6, okay? And we have result after that, 71.64, all right? Let's see lower, -52.36. Okay, it's just the same thing, okay? What you can see sometimes is difference in the very first trade that you have. So here is 68.33 and here is, let's see how much is it. Actually, it's again -52. This comes, guys, because MetaTrader is designed to start the backtesting from the 100 and the first bar. No matter what is the first date or the first bar of your backtest, it will just start calculating from the 101st. That's why EA Studio backtester is more precise, okay, because it starts calculating immediately. But as you can see, after that we have the same results. Let's just compare the date and the time. I will leave it this way, okay, so we ignore the first trade over here and we focus on the second one. So on the second trade, you can see this is 2014 6th of October 2014 6th of October at 700 hours. Okay, so it's a short position. As you can see, the price 125.92, stop loss, everything is the same. All right, guys, this is very important to be done before you start doing anything with your EA Studio. So if you miss to enter the commission, obviously here I would be having the difference of this 0.60, which is exactly actually the commission in this case, with 0.1 and 0.06 as we said if your entry lot is 0.01. All right, guys, I hope everything is clear. Make sure you set in your EA Studio script exactly the spread and the commission and the maximum bars that you want to export. But once again, This video is a proof how good is actually Expert Advisor Studio as strategy creator, because it shows exactly the same entries and exits and MetaTrader, meaning that the strategies that you are creating, the portfolios that we are doing, are just very same thing what have happened. And you see immediately here the balance chart, the statistics, and after you do this check, you can be sure that actually the strategies that you create with EA Studio, with the Expert Advisor Studio, are realistic and you can trade on your MetaTrader. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, you can always drop me an email. Cheers, bye bye.